more than welcome. I mean, you can email me if you have it any time.
Okay.
Why do men have more than one wife, even though in Quran it says only do so? It says only do so if you can do justice between your wives. We all know,
yes,
that most men could not be just. Is this equality?
Anyway,
you are talking about the polygamy in Islam, in general. It's okay. Now, the only book on this earth that says marry one only is Quran. You will not find any book, Old Testament, New Testament, go to the Buddhism, go whatever, you will not find any book. So, why polygamy in Islam? This is the question. Is it against women or not? If you want to analyze it logically, you will find that polygamy is for women, not for men. I don't think that any man will be happy to have four women. I mean, as it is stated in the Quran. Because marriage is a responsibility. And you are the head. If you are the head of the country, it means that you have extra responsibility. What about if you have four homes, four wives, with one, each one of them has her own children, and you are responsible for each of them? So the Quran restricted that if you do justice. And after that it says, if you cannot, marry one only. One. So it's for women. If you want to discuss polygamy now, for example, other religions, if you take the Old Testament, does it talk about the polygamy? Prohibited? No. You will find all the prophets in the Old Testament. For example, Solomon. He got 700 wives. 700. Take, after that, the New Testament. It has no any word about this issue. You can't find any verse prohibit that or with that. Nothing at all. So, if you are talking about the civilian law, you can't find anything says no, women should not be, or men should only marry one woman. Today I was looking at the statistics of America, 2008. And it says that in America, between the age of 15 till the age of 64, they have about 1 million women more than men. If you add to this, you have 2 million gays, sodomites. Then you will have at least 3 million women if you allocate one for each one. Then what's the solution for this woman? We want a practical solution. A woman who wants to keep her chastity. Not prostitution, because prostitution is something immoral. No one can accept that, that a woman goes with anyone. No one accepts that. But if a woman wants to fulfill her desires, where should she go? You have one wife, then you are 3 million women, go on the side. Find me a solution. Half of them, they don't want to marry. Okay. What about the rest? Leave them like this? Go to the church, sleep there, or go to the mosque and sleep there, just worship your God? This is something illogical at all. So you should come up with a solution. The solution is in the Quran by polygamy. So if you look at the Quran, for example, in Islam we have 5 categories, our deeds. There's something obligatory upon every Muslim, like praying. You should do it. Then you go less than that, highly recommended things. You can make extra prayers. Then at the middle you have permissible things you can do. Then just like this you have highly recommended not to do. Then the last thing, forbidden, haram. You cannot do it. Where is polygamy in this category? is permissible. So it is not obligatory upon every Muslim man you should marry for. Not at all. If you go Nuremberg, 1652, they have a war for 30 days. They declare through their parliament that men should marry 10 women. 10! And I think it's applied also as a solution after the Second World War in Europe. But they didn't talk about that. So this is a solution between your hands. It's nothing against the woman. The woman has the right to ask for divorce if she doesn't want to be a second wife. If she doesn't want her husband to marry another one. She has the right from this Islam. And no one said to her, no. But very important thing, that the Muslim woman, as the Muslim man, when we look about our freedom, we don't look at it by ourselves. You look to your freedom in terms of the freedom of the society. When there's a problem for the whole society, you should sacrifice. By this way, some Muslim women, they accept that their sister should not stay at their homes just without a husband. They accept that, and they accept to be two or three or four. It's a big issue.
And this is an exception, not a norm. This is an exception.
Yeah, it's not, for sure. I'm asking here, if there's any Muslim men who are, how many of you married two? None. It's not applied.
I just want to say thank you for the lecture. I just want to add one thing. It's very important to put it there. There is a difference between Islam and culture. The media all the time talk about Islam, how the Muslim treated women very bad, and they give an example in Afghanistan. The women are not allowed to study or not allowed to work. And the whole media say that this is what Islam treated, you know, very bad. But unfortunately, you know, this is 99 other Muslim countries, women study and work like men. And the Prophet, peace be upon him, said that seeking knowledge, education is compulsory for every Muslim, male and female. So the true Islam is, you know, but the media always take one incident and say that, look how the Muslim treat. So this is always different between Islam and culture.
This is what we say always. That if you want to judge Islam, go to its resources. Don't say that in Saudi Arabia they're doing this, in Pakistan they're doing this, in Afghanistan they're doing this. I'm asking, is Saudi Arabia is the equivalent term of Islam in any language? Is it? Is Pakistan equivalent to Islam? Is Egypt equivalent to Islam? Not in any language in the world. But if you want, if you seek some problems, we know our cultures. We have many, many, many problems. But the problem, not because we are so attached to Islam, but we are so detached from Islam. And if you see the real application of Islam, you will see how much the beauty is. Yes. Yes.
Thank you very much for your presentation. But for a long time, I've been at this with lots of people around myself. There are lots of questions I need to answer one day. I promise it's not bad to mention in this session. We can share it with each other. As you said that when you think about the monogamy or polygamy in the United States, you need to think about our issues in our countries, in Muslim world. First of all, about spreading Islam in all the countries, I don't think all these spreading Islams around the world is particularly because of the efforts of the Muslims, like Aisha, Imam Ali, Omar Raziullah, anybody. It's because that Muslims invaded other parts of the world. Because they attacked Iran, because they attacked Turkey, because they went to the